When the sun rises, I wake up and chase my dreams. I won't regret when the sun sets, 'cause I live my life like I'm a beast.
Hey yo, back to make you run around again like it's a fire. I spit acid, bitch, like I got cyanide in my saliva. Watch me wet and heat shit up like I'm a washer and a dryer. While I beat you in your head until you tired.
I'm a motherfucking beast.
See the way we got all my niggas is open. I'm doing it again, tripping in the bones gang. Got a nigga while I like it in the bullpen. Nigga, they wishing the hell of me hoping that I would've managed and I stop and I would finish. But I drop and always kill a nigga hotter than a skillet. Think you fucking with the guard, you gotta be joking. Every single time you niggas see me step inside the door, killing everything with 1,000 gorillas behind me. So I suggest you bounce and let your chick eat my salami slow. While I continue to dazzle niggas in the hood with that tsunami flow.
There she is. Gonna try this bad boy out. Bought 2 flavors. One's just regular coffee. One's a vanilla biscotti. That was the, it's like 0.5 carb. You have to be really careful with these Keurig pods with the flavored coffee, because they are much higher in sugar than they even say on the box. They don't say it at all, actually. All right, let's try her out. I forgot. I need water. I did put half of a Splenda in the cup already. Just gonna use half. It should be enough for sweetness. I wonder if a candle will make me look better. So, first and foremost, ignore the face. I'm on the no makeup, no cares bus tonight. I just don't care right now. So I know I'm so pretty. Just ignore it, okay? I just wanted to sit down and give an update with everything that's going on right now, because I know I haven't. We are 10 weeks out today. 10 weeks out today from Canadian Nationals, the show that I am competing in next. Basically, today was my check-in, and I'd say that this last week was the first week that I didn't progress in any way. So every week I've been improving. Every week the new check-in photos or progress pictures are better, and I'm seeing really good changes. And this week was the first week that that didn't happen. So from last week to this week, there just really wasn't much progress, and I really wasn't happy with my progress pictures today. Things were gonna get harder. Things are going to get harder as we try to get leaner. My body is going to be holding on to fat a lot more than normal. So yeah, that was a little frustrating today. I'm sure you'll see a trend with my videos week to week, is that every week tends to be different in terms of how I'm feeling. So I'm sure you've seen one week I'm feeling great and I feeling like everything's going just fine and I'm making all this progress and I'm feeling muscular and I'm feeling lean. And then it could be like a day later or a week later and I'm feeling not good or low energy or, you know, frustrated or whatever. So in terms of energy and things like that, I'm feeling good. Like, I actually had a good week in terms of that, as in I wasn't feeling like drained or low energy or like starving or anything like that. No negative feelings like that. Just more so frustrated with the lack of progress. It's like my body just stopped responding. I've had some digestive issues, which has been making me a little bloated. So that doesn't make you feel lean. You know, when one day you visibly had, you know, some abs showing, and then like this last like week or so, it's like they're gone. So that's really frustrating, but it really could just be a moment in time and it's gonna pass, things are gonna clear up, things are gonna, you know, regulate, and we'll be good. And I actually do have confidence that this next week, that's what's going to happen, is that everything's gonna start kicking up again. I just have to keep at it, keep doing my cardio, keep doing my training, keep eating what I'm supposed to be eating, and I really feel like this week things are gonna kickstart again. I don't know why, I can just feel it. But yeah, so that's kind of where I'm at right now in terms of prep. Just not really happy with my current state. It's just frustrating. You want to see progress every week. It's good that I didn't go backwards and like I looked worse than last week, but you definitely want to see that things are continuing to build and momentum is building and bigger changes are being made. And when they don't, it's just kind of hard, especially when you're getting closer to the show. So, I mean, I'm 10 weeks out now, and I essentially started prep 10 weeks ago, like at 20 weeks out. So 10 weeks have gone by already, like flew by. And so I'm down to 10 weeks now, and now I'm starting to think, okay, like time's running out. 10 weeks is a long time, but it's also not. And this is just when you start to think like that. As a competitor, you just like, as the numbers get smaller and how many weeks out you are, you start to get a little anxious. Like, am I gonna be ready? But you can't. You just have to keep doing what you're supposed to be doing, listening to your coach, and 9 times out of 10, it will work out. I felt this way last year too. I remember feeling this way at like 4 weeks out from my show, being like, you are not ready to step on stage. Like, how is this going to happen? And then it does. And then the week of the show's here and you did it. So gotta keep that in mind, but I definitely believe in myself, and I know that I'm just gonna continue to kill it and give it my all, and things are going to pick up and things will turn out in the end, for sure. But as of right now, I have a lot of cardio. It's now split in 2 sessions because it's so much. So I was going to the gym once a day. I would be doing my training and then I would do my cardio after, but now that it's increased, it's now split in two, so I now have to go to the gym, do my first cardio session, go back home, eat, and then I go back, do my training, and then do my second cardio session. Of course, I don't want to do 2 cardio sessions, and sometimes I don't get it done. I don't get the second one done in the day, so I end up having to go back after work, which I've twice now I've had to go at like 2:30 in the morning, and I'm there till like 3:30 and then going home, and that's not ideal, and I really don't like doing that, and I'm gonna try to like avoid that happening, but it's happened a couple times when I just haven't got the second session done, and like there's no, I have to go back, like there's no like thinking like, oh, like, oh well, like go to bed, you missed a cardio session, like no, like you have to get it done, like there's no question, can't think about it. You can't think about how tired you are and how good your bed would feel or how nice it would be to just go home and eat or anything like that. You cannot think about what you're doing at this point. You just do. You don't even give yourself the option to not do what you said you're going to do or to not do what you need to do to get a job done. I also stopped training with people like 3 weeks ago, I'd say, 2 or 3 weeks ago. I was going to the gym here and there with a girl from work or like whoever, but I stopped training with people a couple weeks ago just because you can't have the distraction of someone else. I don't know how to say it. I want to focus on my workout. I don't want to talk. I want to really feel and think about what I'm doing. I don't want to be slowed down. I want to do my workout the way I want to do it and not have to modify it because I'm with someone, or slow myself down because I'm with someone, or adjust weight or anything like that. It was just important to kind of like cut that out and just go alone and get the work done. It does take away from your workout, whether you think so or not. Working out with a friend definitely takes away from the intensity of your training. So at this point in prep, I don't recommend it, and I would just rather really, really focus on what I'm doing. It is Saturday night. I got the night off work, which I really, really needed. I needed a day off where I could catch up on life and do laundry and clean my house. So, I mean, the day has flown by. It's 9:40 p.m. And I'm drinking coffee right now because I need to go back to the gym and do my second cardio session. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Finish this coffee, go back to the gym, do 60 minutes on the stairs, and then I'm gonna come back home and I'm gonna edit my videos so I can get them up. And I also need to cook some chicken, and I'll have my last meal of the day as well. So that's the plan. And yeah, that's just a little update, how I'm feeling right now. Not too satisfied, not too happy with my current point in prep. And that's okay. That's just motivates me for this next week to absolutely kill it every single day, win every single day. And I truly believe that this next week will be different, and I'll have a good check-in next Saturday. I just gotta hustle, and I really, really want things to get better and to feel confident in my progress. So, like I said, I'm just gonna kill it and focus and not worry too much about it. I still have plenty of time. There's no need to worry. But it just pushes me to really grind this week. So that's what I'm gonna do. All right, off to the gym, round 2. I'll see you guys later.